Let's talk about where trust currently stands around the world. And so when we look at trust over time, overall, this is according to the Digital News Report, trust in news has rebounded strongly over the last year in almost all countries. So overall trust in news stands at about 44% worldwide. The trust in sources people use most often themselves is up to 50%, and that's an increase from the previous year. Finland remains the country with the highest level of trust in its news organization, 65%. The United States has the lowest level at 29%. What the Reuters Digital News Report of 2021 also found is that the trust gap between news in general and that found in aggregated environments has grown. So what this means is there is a growing trust gap between the news sources people generally rely on and the news they find on social media and when they are searching. And audiences are placing a greater premium on accurate and reliable news sources, which should be good for news organizations that are providing this. And so when you look at that trust gap, what you are seeing is that the amount of trust people have in news overall has increased up about 6 points compared to last year at 44%. But the trust in news when it comes to the news they might find on social media is only at 24%. So that trust gap continues to grow. What the Digital News Report also found is that countries with strong and independent public service media are seeing a greater consumption of trusted news brands. And when you look at that pattern and where that trust is in independent public service media, it becomes less clear outside of Western Europe. Countries where the coronavirus crisis has dominated the media agenda less, and countries where other political and social issues have played a bigger role, you are not seeing that pattern of continued greater consumption of trusted news brands as you are in countries where the coronavirus has not dominated the media agenda and where political and social issues have not played a big role. Television news continues to perform strongly in some countries when it comes to the amount of trust people have in the TV news. Print newspapers are continuing to see further sharp declines almost everywhere. Lockdowns have impacted physical distribution and accelerated shifts towards mostly a digital future. And despite there being more options to read and watch partisan news, a majority of people, according to the Reuters Digital News Report, say that they prefer news that reflects a range of views and lets them decide what to think. Most also are saying that they want news outlets to try to be neutral on every issue. Younger people that were surveyed think that impartiality may not be appropriate in some cases when it comes to social justice issues. Another thing, according to the Reuters Digital News Report in 2021, the value of traditional local and regional news is increasingly based on a small number of subjects, local politics and crime. And so what that is saying is that people are finding that their local news is continuing to focus on a smaller amount of subject matters, and they instead then are relying on internet sites and search engines to look for that other content that's not being provided by local news organizations. And some of that other local content where people say it is best found on the internet or through search engines is weather, housing, jobs, and things to do in a city. Those used to be things that were best found in local and regional news organizations, but people are saying they're not finding it there, and so they are now moving to internet sites and search engines to get that information. So when we look at trust over time, as mentioned previously, United States has the lowest level of trust out of all the countries surveyed. And in the United States, more people distrust the news than trust it. And the Reuters Digital News Report calls this a trust deficit. Some other countries that have a trust deficit are Bulgaria, France, Hungary, Chile, and Argentina. Some of the countries that do not have a trust deficit and where actually there's a very small proportion of people who distrust the media are Denmark, Finland, and the Netherlands. And looking at this graph, when you look at basically people who say they have easy access to news from sources they trust, most people are saying that they do have easy access to news sources they trust. And when you look at, okay, are people willing to pay for news sources they trust? Only 27% of people say they are willing to pay for news sources they trust. And 67% of people only read news that they can access for free. Now let's focus a little bit on the media in the EU. And this is from a global advisor survey from 2019. What this found is that confidence in media in the European Union has been declining over the past 5 years. Overall, this survey found that trust generally decreased across Europe. Specifically, trust in newspapers and magazines in Germany decreased by 12% between 2014 and 2019, but still 65% of Germans trust newspapers. In Spain, 57% do not trust newspapers and magazines very much or at all, and distrust is even higher for online news platforms in that country. This same survey from 2019 found that there's a stark division between highly trusted media in countries like Germany and Sweden and low trust media in Southern Europe, most notably in Spain. When we continue looking at some of these countries and what trust looks like, this 2019 survey found that in France, distrust has dramatically increased throughout the country. And so part of what they contribute to that increase in distrust is yellow vest protest coverage, also a perception of a growing divide between ordinary citizens and the elite in that country. In Italy, they hit in about the middle of the trust curve. Half of people say they generally trust journalists, half say they actively distrust journalists. In Eastern Europe, the trust index there is plummeting, so more people are distrusting news than trusting it. And a couple reasons that they attribute to this is a resurgence of nationalism, a spread of authoritarian and illiberal tendencies, and this is happening especially in Serbia and Hungary. A couple other things that impact someone's ability or possibility of trusting or distrusting news can be how old someone is and their political leanings. And so the Reuters Digital News Report looked at age, and what they found is that in Western Europe, the 18 to 24 age group feels the least fairly represented by the media. And what this means is when they feel they are least fairly represented by the media, they will then be less likely to pay for it. They also feel that there are too little coverage of the issues that they care about. In Western Europe, this is explaining a tendency to embrace alternative and diverse views. It finds on social media, this is a question that they have, is that because there is this age group that is feeling less represented by the media, does that explain that they are going more to these alternative and diverse views that they are finding on social media? And it could be because 40% of people in that age group say that alternative media and social media is their main source of news. And when you look at what that means, what this can tell you is that the younger generation, that 18 to 24 group in Western Europe, is unlikely to pay attention to, pay for news they feel is both unfair or uninteresting. In the United Kingdom, both the left and right feel their political views are unfairly covered. Both the left and the right feel their political views are unfairly covered. There are differences over age, the youngest group feeling least fairly represented by the media, people under 25. There are some gender differences, but those are smaller when you look at who is more likely to trust in news. But if you look at the gender differences in younger people, that is more pronounced, and the difference is more pronounced. In Germany, they are experiencing a similar problem with young people, where people 18 to 24 trust in news less. Also, those on the right are less likely to trust news. They use weaponized terms like lying press to express their unhappiness. When it comes to misinformation and how misinformation and the spread of misinformation impacts someone's ability or willingness to trust news, what the Digital News Report found is that there are global concerns about false and misleading information, and they've only increased this year compared to last year. And some highlights here, 82% of people say that there are concerns about false or misleading info in Brazil. In Germany, that number is 37%. Those who use social media are more likely to say they have been exposed to misinformation about coronavirus than non-social media users. Facebook also, according to this report, is seen as the main channel for spreading false information, according to people who were interviewed. And in the global south, so places like Brazil and Indonesia, messaging apps like WhatsApp are seen as a bigger problem as part of the spread of misinformation.